Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about potential spaces in our body. For this, first we will do a fun activity. Take a balloon and inflate it. Then take a ball and push it inside the balloon like this. Then let the air flow out of the balloon. Now the ball will be covered by two layers of balloon rubber. And there would be a space in between the two. Well, grossly speaking, both the layers would be touching each other due to tight rubber. So, there won't be an actual space. But technically, there would still be a space with zero volume. And that space can be filled with air or anything. Many organs in our body are also wrapped in other structures in such manner. Like, the lungs are wrapped by pleura, the heart is wrapped by pericardium, and intestines are wrapped by peritoneum. And similar to the analogy of balloon, they also have two layers, one inner and one outer layer. And there is a potential space in between. A potential space is also there in the synovial cavities at the joints. These spaces are filled with viscous proteinaceous fluid that lubricates the surface. So, the layers can slide over each other. And one more thing. Most of these spaces have negative pressure. The negative pressure helps hold both the layers together. So these were some basics about the structure of these spaces. Now let's talk about the fluid exchange between the capillaries and these spaces. This one is also simple. See, the surface of tissue surrounding these spaces does not provide much resistance to the passage of fluid, electrolytes and even large proteins. So, they all flow freely between the space and the surrounding tissue. It's like these spaces are just a continuation of the surrounding tissue interstitium. So, the exchange with capillary happens very smoothly via this interstitium. The lymphatic drainage also occurs similarly by nearby lymphatics. In some cavities, the lymphatic channels arise directly from the space also. For example, in pleural and peritoneal cavities. So, large quantity of lymphatic drainage occurs through them. So, this was all about the potential fluid spaces. Now, let's have a quick summary. The potential fluid spaces includes the pleural cavity, pericardial cavity, peritoneal cavity, and synovial cavities. The lubricant-like fluid in the space allows the sliding of two layers. Negative pressure inside it holds the layers together. Fluid exchange with these spaces occurs via the interstitium of the surrounding tissues. And in some cavities, large lymphatics arise directly from the space. That's it for this topic. For sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. In some conditions, extra fluid accumulates in such spaces. The pathology behind it is mostly similar to edema only. But in such spaces, this edema is called effusion. In the abdominal cavity, it's called ascites. That's it for this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.